Turn Up the Sunshine. Now we got news next when we come back. The oldies chosen by Celia Parish in Saltburn by the Sea.
BBC News at 3 o'clock. This is Anthony Birchley. A judge at the High Court has ruled that life support treatment should stop for a 12-year-old boy who has brain damage after being found unconscious at his home in Essex in April. Archie Battersby's parents had wanted his treatment to continue, but doctors at the Royal London Hospital say they think he is brainstem dead. Our correspondent, Sansha Berg, has been following developments.
Holly Dance, Archie's mother, says she is determined to fight on. She says that the family are going to try to appeal, and obviously it will take some time to see whether they're able to appeal. And she says she will do whatever she can to help her son. But obviously, on the other side, the doctors say that Archie is deteriorating and that there is no possibility that he will recover.
A police investigation has been launched after the body of a man was found on fire in a park in Ealing in West London. The emergency services were called at around 4:30 this morning. Boris Johnson has said plans to give the government powers to override parts of the Brexit agreement that cover trade with Northern Ireland are a relatively trivial set of adjustments. The Prime Minister wants to change the protocol he agreed with the European Union to make it easier to move goods between Great Britain and Northern Ireland. The EU has warned the legislation could break international law. The Conservative MP and former Northern Ireland Secretary Teresa Villiers agrees that changes need to be made.
What the Foreign Secretary looks to do is to make what are reasonable amendments to the protocol, which are crucial to saving the political institutions established under the Good Friday Agreement. The protocol as it stands is causing significant political instability, and that just has to be dealt with.
The Prime Minister has defended the government's new food strategy for England. He dismissed claims the plan fails to tackle obesity by leaving out a recommended tax on sugar and salt, and insisted the proposals would allow farmers to grow more food and create more jobs. Our correspondent Claire Marshall has been looking at the paper.
The strategy touts technology and automation as the way forward for farming, boosting productivity to better protect the country from global shocks like the war in Ukraine. Meanwhile, better school meals could be on the menu, with ambitions for 50% of all public sector food to be produced to higher environmental standards or sourced locally. But the strategy has been met with a mixed response. The government's own advisor on food, Henry Dimbleby, says only about half of the recommendations from his independent review have been taken on.
And the Disney Pixar film Lightyear, featuring the Toy Story character Buzz Lightyear, has been banned in Saudi Arabia and several other countries in the Middle East because of a scene featuring a same-sex kiss. The sequence between two female characters had originally been cut from the film in the United States, but it was later reinstated after complaints by Pixar employees. That's the BBC News at 3:03.
Thank you. Here come the oldies.
know what you're wishing for.